Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today, we would like to present about narrative essay. Before we present it, let me introduce our group. My name is Fariza Wahidya Rahma as moderator, and my friend.
My name is Aji Prasetyo as presentator.
My name is Danang as presentator.
My name is Ruwatul Wuska as presentator.
My name is Tiara Basri as presentator.
What is a narrative essay? A narrative is a story. A narrative essay is a story that has a specific point. One, a narrative essay strives to teach a listener. Two, a narrative essay strives to make a specific point. Three, a narrative essay is not a diary entry. The story is linked to the purpose of the essay. What should be included in a narrative essay? Often read in first person, I or we, because it is based on a personal story. Can also be written in third person. Can never be written in second person. Has specific sensory detail to get the reader hooked on the story. Is developed in chronological order. Has verb that help paint a picture and draw in the reader. What else does the narrative essay need? Since this is a story, the narrative essay needs everything a story needs. These are known as the story element. Has a plot, has character, has a problem, has a climax, often use dialogue. When will I use narrative essay? A narrative essay tells a simple story. A narrative essay is not a deeply thought out synthesis. So this essay form shall be used sparingly for colleagues. Course, unless it is specifically assigned. Next.
Essay. Write a thesis statement, just as with any other essay. Brainstorm for a personal story of observation that illustrated or proved the thesis statement. Outline or weave the important part of the story to be told. Write an introductory paragraph that includes the thesis statement, and then write the story. Because this is a story, use a mini paragraph as necessary to tell the story. Write the conclusion, the reflect on the thesis statement. Start with a thesis statement. The thesis will depend upon the story to be proven. The thesis can be something general in the case of a narrative essay. For example, you may write, often times people do not follow simple direction. However, this campers learn just how important following direction can be. What will you expect from this thesis? As the reader, you will expect to learn why following direction is important. As the reader, you will expect to read a story about camping. As the reader, you will expect there to be a twice in the action.
Outline the part of the story and write out the story. An informal outline of the story. To camper, go camping and ignore rules. They leave out food. An animal find the food. One of the camper tries to scare off the animal. Camper learn to follow the rules. Let's read the essay, the introduction. It was a wonderful week to camp in the great outdoor. Even if some of their friends took it was a strange way to honeymoon. Buddy and Jeff were looking forward to their week at Great Smoky Mountain National Park in Tennessee. Little did they know what a learning experience this trip will be. Oftentimes, people do not follow the simple direction. However, this camper learned just how important following direction can be. Next. Setting the scale of the story. After a scenic drive through the glorious mountain, Buddy and Jeff arrived at the camping. A ranger at the boat handed them a map and asked, "Have you ever camped with us before?" A better question would be, "If we ever camped before?" Jerry answered wryly, "You will be fine. Just remember, this is a hot. We do have bear and other animal in the area, so look your foot up in the car," said the ranger as he handed them a list of do and don. Developing the plot, exhausted from their first attempt at setting up a campsite, Roddy and Jeff crawled inside the tent that evening. Giggling and whispering to each other, they dozed delicately inside the tent and ignored the world outside the canvas. The ranger list was left lying on the tent floor.
Continuing the action, vivid word choices. Just before sunrise, Jeffrey was awed by the sound of metal rapping. He quit sleeping out of tent. A fully grown black bear was sitting on the chair picnic table busy prilling to lid off the other day, neck lighted to store in the car the night before. Finding the pawn of bacon that he prized, the bear leaned back on this hind, haunches and began and before the bacon. Jeffrey started screaming in the car. "Get out of here! What do you think you're doing?" Reaching the climax. By this point, most of the other campers had exited their own tent and watched the scene unfold. The bear was not almost be Jerry's training, especially with the remainder of the bacon at stake. The black bear stood on top of the picnic table to this full height. Well, the bear actually stood only 4 feet tall. The extra height of the table caused him to loom over Jeffrey's head. The bear suddenly fell forward, striking the table with a full weight and snarled. The table moored in the response. The climax continues, much more quickly than any way activated. The bear legs of the hawk, menacing for the word Jerry, furled into Jerry's eyes as he turned and ran back into his tent. Zip! Close the zipper. Now One can only imagine how much time passed before Jeffrey entirely realized the futility of the preventive action. How was a flimsy flap of canvas going to stop a fully full-sized angry bear?
Finding the solution. Fortunately, the bear was much more interested in the leftover bacon than in Jerry and Trudy. The bear cautiously turned around, climbed back on top of the table, and continued to eat his early breakfast. He carefully examined the remaining breakfast. He carefully examined the remaining contents of the cooler, finding nothing else as delectable as the bacon. The bear jumped off the picnic table, grunted like his paws and mouth, and then lumbered off into the deeper woods that surrounded the campground. The concluding paragraph. The audience that had gathered applauded spontaneously, then slowly returned to their own campsite, shaking their heads in disbelief. Meanwhile, inside the din canvas tent, Trudy and Jeff had lit their lantern and were carefully studying the items list on the do's and don't list. The rest of their trip was blissfully peaceful as they made sure to follow all the rules at the campsite. Additional ideas for your thesis. Without a thesis or a point, you're not really writing a narrative essay, but a narrative. Make sure to have a point. You can get help finding a point when you first think about sayings or quotes that teach a lesson. Think about lesson learned from Aesop's fables. Then think about a time when you learn something valuable. Read quotations to spawn ideas, and read your own journals for a time something happened worth telling others about. That's all we can say to discuss about narrative essay. We apologize if there are mistakes. Thank you for watching. And thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.